Good morning, YouTube. This is CM Maritime History here, back at another video. I know it's been a long time since I've recorded a video, and I know I should, you know, of course, keep recording videos. But I thought I'd take a little bit of a break and explore some of my new ocean liner books I've recently purchased. And let me just say, videos are going to keep rolling out pretty steadily over the next few months because I have a lot of new topics. So, over the next few weeks, maybe even months, we will have a series on ocean liners that never were, or because the source I'm using is actually a great passenger ships that never were by David L. Williams and Richard P. Decabrec. I think I said that right. But anyway, that is a new book that I got. We're going to use that as one of our topics, a few of our topics for the next several weeks into months. So the first ship, I should say, I thought I'd talk about is the Geddes whale ship, which it was known as because it had the appearance of a beluga whale. Now, you can see in the background, that is the actual ship. I could only find one non-licensed photo that I could, not photo, but image that I could use for the video, so this is the only one we got. I've never seen it before, but in the book they actually have a, I'm not sure if I'll be able to find it. Maybe I'll put it in a thumbnail if I can find it. But they actually have the diagram for the ship, which is kind of cool. But the Geddes whale ship was used with a philosophy of modernism and was designed by Norman Bell Geddes, hence the name Geddes whale ship. And he, Mr. Geddes, realized that if you reduce resistance, the vehicle or object in vehicle in this case, but an object would go faster. So Mr. Geddes realized that. And to quote the book, Mr. Geddes registered patent D0091759 on October 25th, 1933, which was then followed on November 1st, 1933, by letters of patent D0049617 and D0049618. These were all entitled "Design for a Boat." This boat would be the Geddes whale ship. He would call it the liner of the future. Now, this is what is known as a streamlined ocean liner. They are not very big in terms of how much they were built. Like, they were not a very popular style back in the 1930s. This was proposed in 1938, just before the outbreak of the Second World War. If you guys have ever watched this movie, but if you would like to, on YouTube, they have the, I forget what channel it is, but anyway, on YouTube, there's a movie called The Big Broadcast of 1938, and it's a Paramount film from the year 1938 about two ocean liners in a race. One of them is called a Colossal, but it's pretty much a model of the Normandy, down to the exterior appearance. It looks like the Normandy, versus the Gigantic, which is a model of the Geddes whale ship. So judging by how it was used in the movie, this probably would have been used as the lounge back here. The bridge is this sort of Queen Mary II-esque structure up here, and down here would be storage, crew quarters up here. I'm just judging this off the diagram and how it was used in the movie, but nobody really knows that one because it was never built. So it also would have featured one of the features that would be used on ships later on, which is known as the X-bow, which would be used in cruise ship designs in the 21st century. And Bell Geddes patent explained that while the underform of the hull was more conventional, it will be understood that the portion of the boat which is normally visible, i.e. that part which is normally above the water line thereof, is a dominant feature of my design, which is a quote from Mr. Geddes. And the intended gross tonnage was not stated for the liner of the future. But behind the second funnel, which you cannot really see in this design because it was later removed, the second funnel was actually an aircraft hangar, and it would be launched off a catapult like you would see on like battleships or destroyers, say like the Arizona or the Missouri. And that's how they would pretty much be similar to the Bremen in Europa, because they would launch their mail on a plane one day early and have it sent off the ship to go someplace. No, not someplace, but the destination of the ship one day later. But according to Mr. Geddes' book Horizons, the length of the ship would have been 1,088 feet, which would have, if it had been built, make it longer than the Queen Mary and the Normandy, if I'm not mistaken. I just noticed the book actually describes it here. On the aft funnel, there would have been a launch ramp, not a catapult. And the design for boat patents provide very little information on the engineering aspects of the vessel's structure. And, of course, it was very, very, very uncommon for the streamlined hull. And a later ship design that we'll talk about would be the Knapp roller boat, which is also mentioned in this this page. Now, spoiler for the movie, the Gigantic wins the race, but the models of the ships that were used for the big broadcast in 1938 were actually never found again. They were used, and nobody knows what happened to them. To my knowledge, there is not a photo of the Gigantic outside of the movie, but there is a model. There is a photo of the Colossal, the model Normandy, being built, which I think is cool. If you just look up, like, big broadcast 1938 ship models, it should show up in there, but it's hard to find. You have to scroll down. This took me a while to find. But Norman Bugatti's whale ship was very revolutionary for its time, and it was actually offered to be built by none other than Benito Mussolini in the late 30s and early, I believe, just before, up until the Second World War hit. Mussolini offered to build it. However, Mr. Geddes decided that he would rather have an American shipbuilder build it. But of course, that never happened due to, still stockpiling the money from getting more money back from the era of the Great Depression. And, of course, you know, having the Second World War, that also never, because of those things, it never happened. But, it would still be cool, say, if somebody made that today. However, because of cruise ship design, it would be a little bit more commonplace than back then. So, I hope you guys have enjoyed this video on the Geddes whale ship. I know it's a little unorthodox, because we typically cover actual ocean liners instead of plans. So, I thought, maybe the next video, like I said earlier, is going to be the Knapp roller boat, which actually made it a step further than the Geddes whale ship, and we actually had a Tesla model of it built, but I'll reveal what happened to that model in the next video. Stay tuned, guys, and if you have any video suggestions, please let me know down in the comments. See you guys. Bye.